In this video, I'm going to show you all the mods that I've done on my Kawasaki Vulcan S. Let's get into it. Hey guys and welcome back. My name is Vinny and you're watching V-Ride. And now I'm going to show you all the mods that I've done on my Kawasaki Vulcan S. Now, it's not a lot. It's not a lot compared to what I've seen other people do on their Vulcan S's, but I just thought I'd share with you what I've done on my bike. Now, if you are new here, then subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification button so every time I make a new video, you guys are the first one to know. And if you do like this video, then hit that like button too. Now the first thing I want to show you is this windshield, and this is a factory fit windshield which actually came with my bike. So my bike's model is called Kawasaki Vulcan S Cafe. So this is the addition that they've done in the Cafe model. And it's got these brackets over here, so you can actually remove this windshield. It's detachable. I actually quite like this windshield, so I've just left it on. And I know it's not really a modification, but I know a lot of other Vulcan S's do come without the windshield, so I just thought I'll include that in this video. The next thing I want to show you is these hand wind deflectors or hand guard, whatever you want to call it. Now, I didn't put them on to protect my hands from debris or anything like that. I just put them on because I ride in Melbourne and it gets really, really cold over here. And I usually ride about 100 kilometers in and out of work. So this helps me a lot. It protects my hands a lot. Even with the sort of heavy gloves, your hands get really, really cold, and this sort of protects my hands and keeps them warm. The next thing I want to show you is this rear seat. Now, if you are buying Kawasaki Vulcan S, be mindful that a lot of Kawasaki Vulcan S's that come out of the showroom don't come with the rear seat or the foot pegs, so be mindful of that. It just comes with that riding seat and nothing else on the back. So this is the rear seat that I have attached. Now this is not the Kawasaki model seat. This is just the one that I bought from eBay. It does the job for me. I don't really ride with pillion riders too much, so it does the job for me. But I do plan on getting it sort of customized a little bit, which will make it a bit more comfortable than what it is right now. So with the rear seat, I had to attach the foot pegs. So you can see, so as I said earlier, guys, if you are planning to buy this bike, then the Kawasaki Vulcan S does not come with the foot pegs or the rear seat. So you gotta be mindful of that. So I've attached these, and these are the ones from Kawasaki. So they are the OEM model. And I can't remember how much I paid for it, but yeah. The next thing is the sissy bar and the tail bag rack. Or the tail rack. Now I do have another tail rack that sort of goes here. To do that, I'll have to remove a seat, and that's the original Kawasaki tail rack. It sort of curved a little bit. I didn't really like that because it was curved a little bit and it was a bit hard for me to put my tail bag on. So I sort of decided to put the rear seat, get the sissy bar with the tail rack, and now I can attach this tail bag onto it. And that's the next thing I wanted to show you, my tail bag. Nothing fancy. It's again one of those things that I bought off, I think I did buy it from eBay, and it's called Rock Biker. Now if you want to see a video of how I've attached this this Rock Biker onto my tail bag, I made another video about that, so I'll put that link in the description, although that video was made when I had the original Kawasaki Vulcan S tail rack, so I attached this tail bag onto that rack. This sissy bar is again from eBay. It's not anything fancy or anything like that, but it does the job. It's pretty sturdy and I actually quite like it. It's nice and comfortable too. The next thing I want to show you is my saddlebags. Now the saddlebags that I've got are Viking saddlebags, and I quite like the look of it. It actually looks really nice with the bike and when they're on the bike. At the moment I've only got one on just for the just for this video. Usually I put both of them on. The best thing about these bags I like is they've got a lock on, so if I'm going on long rides I can fill this up and I can just lock them and, you know, go to a cafe, get a coffee or whatever. I don't have to worry about it too much. The other thing I had to buy with this bag is these detachable mounts, and I got these mounts from a website called Finmoto. I'm not an affiliate with Finmoto or anything like that, but if you want I'll put the link in the description. Just comment below and I'll send you the links. But it's quite handy actually, these things. It's got a lock over here and you can just remove this saddlebag, and you know, it's easily removable and attached again. The next thing I want to show you is the Delkovich 40mm bullnose exhaust that I've recently attached. It's an absolute banger. I mean, the exhaust notes that you get from this is just absolutely fantastic. I did make a video recently about the comparison in between the stock exhaust and the Delkovich bullnose exhaust, so I'll put that link in the description again. And the last thing is these swing arm spools that I've attached. Now they're quite handy little things when you are servicing your bike, or even, you know, sort of cleaning your chain or whatever. I usually put the put my bike on a stand, and it's quite easy to do. I made a video about that, so if you want to watch it, you'll find that link in the description, and you will also find a link to for the chain cleaning techniques or tips to clean the chain as well. But anyways, these things, they don't cost much, but they are very, very useful. I highly recommend you buy these, because you can put your bike on a stand and your bike can stay upright, and it's a lot easier to do the service on your bike when it's upright. Guys, I hope you liked the video. If you did, hit that like button. It really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And if you know of other people who've done mods on their Kawasaki Vulcan S, then maybe comment below in the video, and maybe I'll end up doing some of the mods that you say. All right, guys, I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.